is ready to go home.
I'm planning to leave like real early Wednesday to get there as fast as I can before everyone going there.
When the evacuation order is lifted, Hamill and thousands of others who have been staying in Alberta and Manitoba will head north. The Yellowknife's mayor is warning people to be prepared in case the fires flare up again.
Having some food and water in your vehicle. And just recognizing that a lot of times, I know when folks drive up into TL and if they like to stop off at high level and stay for the night, that might not be an option.
We have 999 hotel rooms, and every one of them is booked.
Here in high level Alberta, businesses are stocking up, and the evacuation center has 300 cots for people to stop and rest.
We'll just welcome them and provide them with some, you know, compassion and hope. So we're ready for the. I don't know how many people have been coming in, but
other Northerners are also jumping in to help. Jane Gronewagen is opening up her ranch for Yellowknife campers for free.
We're very happy to be able to help people out, and some people have asked us about paying. I don't know. This is just our little part.
But not everyone is rushing to get home. Elise Legat has cancer. She's worried about going back to limited health services.
I'll just get the care that I need and the test that I need and not be a burden.
Canadian officials say some medical services won't be online for a month and that city programs and schools will also need some time to get up and running again. And we here in the Detroit area have seen evidence in our own air quality from those wildfires, and many of them are still burning.
And we still have it. You went outside right now and you looked up, it's not, even at sunset, it's still a little kind of tinted, a little more milky white. Yeah,
yeah,
we still have some of that in there. You can see actually some of that there. And when we get into the next month or so, there are still fires burning in Western Canada, still large ones. We haven't really cooled down much. Today is the perfect example. And tomorrow is also another one. We've got 70s tomorrow morning to start off for your morning commutes as everybody gets back to the grind. Beautiful weather, definitely out of the ordinary. It's far above our average marks. Are we breaking any records? No. Did we get close today? Yes. It's one of our warmest Labor Days that we've had. We're going to have that listing tonight at 11 o'clock on CBS Detroit. But we're not quite in that record-shattering place. It's just hot. It's definitely one of the warmer ones. 70s, though, tomorrow morning as kids head off to school. Upper 80s to 90 as they come home. And that is why Shana was mentioning, a couple of schools are closed for tomorrow. They just don't have the air conditioning resources needed to make it something that kids are able to go through with. So once we get past that point, we are looking at then rain. We got some rain chances going into tomorrow later in the day, mainly west of I-75. You can see where a couple of those showers are going to pop up right here going into the evening commute, and then it's done. Not everybody's going to see the rain. And when you do see the rain, it's very quick, and then it's gone. But keep an eye out, especially late in the day if you have any evening plans. Now, once we get past that point, the other portion here is a cold front swinging its way on through right there, midday and through the afternoon. On Wednesday, with some showers and a couple of storms as well, watch right here, because as we get later into Wednesday night, a few more showers swing their way on in, with Wednesday as a wet day. And Thursday, just raining.
Oh, wait, one second, Dave.